And we're back, fellow knife enthusiasts. I'm Cee, and this is...
Jul.
Wow.
Yep.
Just Jul.
Flip it up.
And we picked the jets. Yeah. Picked out some of the newest
items. Get your crap straight.
Crap straight? Can you straighten crap?
Yes.
All right. Boker, Kizer, Civivi.
And Cansip. Anything to declare before we get right into it?
Oh, she moved all of her baking stuff out. We gathered it up and put it on table. So take it out of here.
Wait, who are we talking about?
Mother-in-law.
Oh, that's right. That's right. Okay, well, everyone knows once the baking stuff is out, the rest is just gravy.
She hasn't taken that to her house yet.
Oh, wow. So our first Boker is, guess what, guys? The Magnum M-spec Survival Knife. And yes, I did that really close to my face.
The Magnum MSSK for short.
Yeah. So, we're just going to get right to the specs.
Jump on in, like a pool.
I wish we had one of those. Has a solid handle made of indestructible, there's quotations there, FRN with OD green rubber coating to allow for non-slip grip even in wet conditions. The black party element further increases work safety. The opening in the handguard, which is reminiscent of the barrel ring of a bayonet, allows the user to fix the knife with string, wire, paracord, cable ties, etc. Anything you want to make into a makeshift spear. If the need arises, of course.
The Bowie blade, made of stainless 7CR 17 MOV steel, is 7.87 inch with a black finish and typical back saw.
Whoop, whoop.
The whole shebang is 12.4 inches overall and is additionally equipped with a built-in compass as well as practical fire starters.
Hold on.
I'm going slower. And
there
belt loop designed for an integrated clip.
So there's the fire starters and the ferro rods and the whatever else you need there. Okay.
Yep.
And the whole shebang is available at AtlanticKnife.com for just $34.95.
There it is.
Yep.
All right. I'll start.
Okay, great.
I like these new knives. I like the price range of them. I like the styling of them. It's nice to have a Boker survival knife. It's not like $400.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I feel like I could use it. I might just give it a try.
Yeah, I think for the price, the materials, the look, the sheath, I mean, one really couldn't go wrong with getting one of these. I mean, you're not going to be upset if you mess it up accidentally or on purpose, or you lose it. I mean, I can picture myself just like using it for all the things you're not supposed to use it for. Because I'm like, it's just $34. I don't care. I'll get it cut and done. I'll just get another one. It's a knife for budget survival, okay?
Is that a thing?
It is now. Budget survival knives. Find them at AtlanticKnife.com. Because who said surviving had to be expensive?
Amen.
Yeah, I know.
So the next knife. The Boker Magnum.
Hold on. Put it in the wrong way.
There you go. I hate how they can't go in both ways.
Yeah.
I think this one can.
Or the Magnum.
Boker Magnum, John J. Survival Knife. Go ahead.
JJSK for short.
JJSK. That's what they call on you now, JJ. Do you know that? Eerily similar to the Magnum MSSK. This is too...
That's part ATV, part SUV, first certified by the DMV.
Yep.
Yeah.
I know what you're wondering right now. Where am I change? All right. Ready?
Yeah, go.
Survival Knife. This blade is 13.58 inch overall with an 8.07. Just a little bit longer than Jul's hand can stretch.
Yep.
7CR, 17
cats want one.
MOV, black Bowie.
Especially in
there. We have cats and dogs here. They wander the shop. They come on in. If a new one wanders up, Wendy just accepts it too. Starts feeding it, you know. So, handle is black FRN and sports a rubber coating along with symmetrical peri. Allowed to increase safety and ensure strong grip control.
Just like that. I hope the camera person goes back and like flashes to you when you say that.
I did a little hand movement too.
Yeah. Okay, so finally, this black beauty comes with a black form-fitting plastic sheath. Give me 1 second. So, gotta make sure that there we go.
I thought you were going to do that. Cats and dogs and whatever the saying, I forget.
Aw, this is a little sheath shimmy. Oh, no.
That looks pretty good to me.
Okay, good. Which offers a large range of fastening and carry options due to the openings in the handguard. One is able to attach the knife, like the other one, with string, wire, paracord, etc. to make a makeshift spear. Mm-hmm. I'm not sure when that needle will rise for you guys, but, you know, you never know. There's also an opening for a lanyard hole, or a lanyard in the end of the knob here, right there. So.
All right. So why don't you tell us what you think about this blade?
Well, this one is a little bigger than the other one. Mm-hmm. It's all black, but same materials, very similar in style, same price. I think I get two. Especially since I won't mind really using these knives, like I said, if you know what I mean. I mean, I'm going to just hack away at whatever I'm using it for.
Oh, you're going to use it for every portion that you can possibly think of.
That is nice.
Anything that you can think about using it for.
Exactly. If I go, you know what, I might use this.
You need to get a limb, we're going to cut that sucker down.
Now, the sawbacks are a little different. The teeth, this one's a little wider and spans the spine of the blade a little more. Mm-hmm. But I feel like this one's going to be, I don't know, I like them both. I get one of each. Instead of getting two of this one, I get one of each.
All right.
What about you?
Well, I like the basicness of it. I do like the green handle better, but, you know, I think I would rather have the little bit longer one.
Yeah, I kind of like the longer one too, but I like the green.
I don't like the whole, you know, the ferro rod, well, whatever you want to call it, the
fire starter
and the compass and all that stuff. That to me just seems like, I'll bring a compass. Don't worry.
I'll bring a Swizza. Is that what it is?
No,
Silva. Silva compass. Yeah. Little blue one that attaches to a key ring. There it is. Mm-hmm. I like that one. Okay, so that does lead us to the Kizer Mini Bed Glider, which comes in three different versions right now. There's a red, black, and green micarta. So we got the red one and the black micarta.
And Joel doesn't think that the red micarta looks like micarta.
Yeah, it doesn't feel like micarta, it doesn't look like micarta, but if they say it's micarta, so that's what we'll
see. Then I guess we'll just have to believe them, won't we? Alright, ready?
Sure.
This bed glider is 6.5 inch overall with a 2.7 inch satin finish. Stainless Boker N690 reverse tanto blade.
Or Warncliffe style.
There it is. This mini bed glider is the latest reimagined vision of the original Kizer bed glider. This liner lock is deployed with a dual-sided thumb stud, mm-hmm. has jimping for extra grip while precision cutting. Finally, this compact carry features a lanyard hole, tip-up pocket clip, barrel spacers, and the infamous Kizer cleaning cloth.
Which is right there.
Dun dun dun.
Okay, very nice, very nice. And it's all for the low price of $55 from
AtlanticKnife.com.
Alright. You know what I think of these?
Nah, I can't think like that.
I think Kizer is trying to create their own knife niche. I mean, they have made several compact pocket knives. For the discerning shopper who wants like a one-bladed snazzy mini folder that fits good in the pocket. I mean, this can't be a coincidence that they've released like, I don't know, 5-6 new mini compact carries in the past few months.
I don't think it's a coincidence.
I don't think so either. I think they're trying to do this. They're trying.
Yeah.
All right, so go ahead. What do you think of this one?
Well, I mean, I like it.
Here.
I wish it was a little bit longer because I like longer knives. But
really?
It has good styling. I like the blade shape. It is a Kizer. It's easy to open. Reminds me of a lot of other knives that they make, but it's a nice knife. I like the red, too. It's a really nice red.
I wish it felt like micarta. It doesn't feel like micarta. It feels like G10.
Fits in your pocket well, too.
Yeah, it does fit in the pocket. Mm-hmm. I like it more than the other mini bed glider with, like, the plain style. I like this one with like the Warncliffe reverse tonneau. I'm not sure though if I like it more than the original, because the original was like 8 inches overall, mm-hmm. this one's 6.5, and I like having a bit extra handle to work with.
Well, you like playing with it because you didn't click it like 57 times.
I do like the clicking when you close it.
Greg Medford would have you right now.
Yeah, well, luckily it's not a Medford.
So. Luckily.
And compact carries are nice and all, but I think Kizer should be thinking about their clientele, who are mostly men at this point in time, and they got big hands. I mean, I understand maybe throwing something this in your pocket just to cut a string later,
mm-hmm.
but...
Well, they sell all across the world, too.
So. Yeah, well, I guess that does make sense.
Everybody's not all big like us Americans.
Yeah, that must be it. That's just my thought, though.
Gotcha.
Okay. Anyways, all right. Go ahead.
Same old thoughts. I had the same ones I had when I talked about it a few minutes
ago. That's
great.
Uh-huh. Yeah. We're on to the new knife of the Civivi Imperium.
All right.
But like always, please make sure to like, share, comment, and subscribe.
That way, we get subs and you get to be part of the knife conversation.
That's great. Mm-hmm. And you get in our giveaway. So right now on the YouTube, we're giving away the steel will maybe...
Come on now.
I can't. It's been sitting.
Hit the bar on it. There you go. It's been... Did you just say it's been sitting?
sitting. Yeah. I haven't. Yeah. It's new. I haven't flipped it.
It's got stiff sitting there.
Yeah. It is.
All right. Over on AtlanticKnife.com. Which you can find at the top of the page. Click the home button. Blog appears. Or you can go halfway down the page and blog is there. Or you can go all the way to the bottom of the page and the blog is there. I mean,
everywhere is the blog.
So that's where our blog. Everywhere, blog. You're trying to quack your own duck again. There you go. All right.
And you'll be entered to win.
I'm getting ready.
I know.
If you answer the trivia question, you'll be entered to win the Steel Wheel 230 Druid.
Yeah, they're nice. So they're both waiting for you, so make sure to enter before it's too late.
Somebody's going to win. They might as well be you.
We also got Southern Grind hats.
Oh, yeah. We're going to add a lot of hats and shirts this week.
A lot of hats.
All right.
That one. Look at that American flag.
America.
That's
love
nice.
It. Gotta love it or leave it, you know?
Uh-huh. No, I love it. You can... Oh, I got you. Okay. Anyways, on the Civivi Imperiums.
All right. They're available in several different versions.
Yes.
Are you ready?
Yeah, go ahead.
I'm ready. There's the Jul J G10.
That's
the
nice.
Multiple micarta colors, brown, olive, green, and dark green.
Mm-hmm.
The shredded carbon fiber versions with gold, silver, or copper-colored flex, dipped in clear resin.
And I have to say, I am absolutely in love with the shredded carbon fiber ones, especially the silver one we have here. Snazzily breathtaking.
That is the second time you've used snazzy in this episode.
Well, thanks for the count.
So, we have the micarta version here, along with the silver shredded carbon fiber.
Like freaking Count Muppet here.
Each Imperium is 7.83 inch overall. Mm-hmm. Time you said snazzy. With a 3.47 inch flat ground blade with.
Jumping.
There it is.
So, some are Damascus blades, like the micarta ones. Others are Nitro V.
Mm-hmm.
So, this one right here, which comes in about 59.61 on the 8s are C. This one has the stonewash finish along with the gold flecked version, whereas the copper one has a black finish.
There we go. The blade thickness is 0.12 inch.
There you go, guys.
Backspacers are G10, and the clips are right tip-up carry. Wow, got tongue-tied there. So finally, these liner locks operate on cage ceramic ball bearings, feature a discreet lanyard hole, and are opened with the front flipper tab.
And there's the Hamartia, isn't it?
Therein lies the rub.
Jeez.
All right. Well, I think I can say the same thing I say every other time we have this. It's a really nice knife. I like the look of it. I like the style of it. I like the blade shape. I hate front flippers.
Someone brought these in and said, we got Civivi Imperiums. And I said, really? And I read the outside of the box and it said shredded carbon fiber, silver. And I was like, oh my goodness, this is going to be my new carry.
But hold on.
I pull it out and I look at the handle and I go, oh my goodness, I love this so much.
They do have thumb studs there.
No.
Yeah, I know, it's not the same.
Except
but
for the front flipper.
This makes me
I do not like dig it. On front flippers, okay?
Ain't digging on
like
the swine.
I don't know. It's just one blow after another. And I really like this handle, too, and I really want to get one. Then I saw the front flipper, and then...
That's life.
Gosh, I picked the wrong week to stop amphetamines, man. It's just the wrong week. It's just all piling up.
I guess that happens.
My click is ticking like this.
Your tick is clicking?
my clock is ticking. That's
your
what clock, it is.
You're supposed to tap your foot three times.
Well,
like any
I can't
more
reach
we can
it.
Put on top of this?
I can't reach all it. Right. Okay, good. Well. Okay, anyway, as I said, I do like this good release from Civivi. It doesn't top the Elementum in popularity, but, you know, maybe they'll release a back flipper stud one.
Hmm?
You don't know. They could.
Yeah.
Like, oh.
If and buts for candy and nuts. We'd all have a Merry Christmas.
Yeah, well, that's great. Well, we can all have a happiest Christmas this side of the nut house, okay?
Oh,
they just add a back flipper. There it is.
Oh, wow. And anyone can have a happy Christmas with one of these Civivi Imperiums.
Wow, wait a... That's a nice
one. Yep. Starting at just 69 bills. Count them out. Ones. Yeah, like you're at the club.
You know all about that, huh?
I don't know anything about it.
Wife.
Never been there.
Comes with a pouch and a sticker.
Hey.
Look at that sticker. I have this on my computer right now.
Where did you get an extra sticker from?
An extra sticker.
That leads us to the next knife up on the table.
The last one, actually.
Are you ready?
Yep, go
ahead. It's the Cancept Wedge.
Which is available, just like the Civivi Epurium, in a few different color options. So there is a red and jewel jade G10. They're not the same. There's a red one, and then there's a jewel jade one, but they're both G10. And there's also a green and brown micarta version, and there's also a black carbon fiber version as well.
And they're ready to wedge themselves between you and your wallet. For only $79.
Christmas one and now the
AtlanticKnife.com. I'm trying my best.
Real nice. Okay.
I used to be the master of the pun.
Well, that's a crown you want to take back.
I passed it on to Crispy. I figured he was just a pun.
That's great. Okay. I'm sure he'll appreciate that. So, on to the specs. So, I do have the Jewel J G10 and the Green Micarta one here today.
Mm-hmm.
Both are lockbacks. And are 5.5 inches overall. You know what? I can add my own sound effects, okay? I don't care. They have 2.25 inch 154 cm stonewash finish stainless clip point blades. Each comes with a, hold on, pause for effect.
It's not yet famous.
Cancep pouch.
But will be.
And cleaning cloth.
There it is.
Yep. And then of course the black pouch is nylon, so.
Finally, the blade is deployed using the faux blood groove.
Yeah, so.
Or fur.
I don't think I can do it that way. I just pull it open like that, though. Like that. There you go. I'll go first.
All right, fine by me.
I think they are very old school in style. They kind of got like a classic Barlow-shaped handle. Very good in the pocket knives. Yes, pocket twice. No pocket clip, but I don't think this is the style of knife that really needs it. Not really. 154 cm steel is high quality. You can get a handle in micarta, G10 carbon fiber, all of which I like, all of which are excellent choices. Overall, I have to say I like this one. I'm not usually a big fan of, you know, plain pocket knives, but I kind of like this one.
Hmm.
What about you?
Well, I had one of the same thoughts that you did, but it reminds me of a Finch.
A Finch.
And I can't remember which one.
The Rentley?
Oh,
the
man, not
Holiday.
The Rentley. The one that's supposed to be, look like the old pocket knife style. Maybe
The 1929. Yes.
Maybe that's it.
That's it.
It does have a nice Barlow sticker. Look to it, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Like like a modern take
on a Barlow.
On an older knife. Mm-hmm. I think that's what they called it. I mean, for a pocket knife, I don't see why I wouldn't have one.
Exactly, and you get the pouch and the cleaning cloth as usual, so.
I don't normally carry a pocket knife.
Yeah, I don't either, but I think I might carry this one.
You know what?
Just to throw it
in. No, the knife's not going to hurt.
Exactly.
Alrighty.
Go ahead.
My turn?
Still your turn, yep.
Alright, great. So, I guess I need to say, would you have one of these?
Yes, I definitely have one of those.
Hmm.
Probably a shredded carbon fiber, but maybe the Jewel Jade, too.
I got my next pun coming up. So,
you
know who is good at driving a wedge.
Wow, you need to stretch it out like
between
that.
Happiness and me. Go ahead.
But that one took some thought. Don't tell us.
I don't know, did it?
Did it have to be?
A mother-in-law.
Wow, that was a surprise.
Yeah.
That's great. So, we know you were just.
Well, I don't really have a big story about it this week.
No big story.
You said she was taking some of her stuff out, but she couldn't. I sent all my kids over there to help her unpack.
I'm sure they love that.
Oh, yeah. They were ecstatic. One of them's kind of a sucker. And she likes to go do that stuff.
Sucker.
You know what I mean. Yeah, they fall for anything more than once.
Yep.
She'll
appreciate that, too. She watches.
They couldn't put anything away. Her table was broken. Needed to be fixed.
What has the table have to do with anything?
Well, she couldn't set the table up. Put the chairs on it. So her little cushions and all the little stuff she has to put on it. So they couldn't do that. Couldn't put anything in the cabinet because the drawers weren't in right, or the cabinet shelves weren't in right. She didn't have shelves in this closet, didn't have shelves in that closet, didn't have a bar in this closet, didn't have a bar.
Okay,
she couldn't do anything.
Do you know when you walk into a house, there's not a bunch of stuff in closets?
Yeah, but like there was no bar even there to hang up shirts.
So she had all these. Hang up clothes.
They basically just walked around in circles and looked at each other and sat down and said, wow, that's a lot of work. Couldn't find no. Well, I went over there, got some shelves for her, all that stuff. I couldn't find no tools. I mean, I found some of my tools. But I couldn't find out of her tools. You know, so that's kind of how it is now. She hopes to be out by July.
Hopes.
Mm-hmm. already had her stuff moved.
Weren't we hoping, like, 3 months ago that she was moving out, and then...
I don't know why you'd want to have a house.
4 years.
And a payment, I'm assuming.
Yeah.
And all your stuff in it, and just go over there each day and look at it and move it around for a month. To me, it don't make no sense.
Maybe she doesn't
want to. Oh, she'd have her bed put together and all. You know, she is...
I think she wants to stay.
Yeah, she is older.
Don't tell me why she wants to stay, because I've met you. So. But... Why does she...
Oh, that's mean.
That's mean. She apparently doesn't want to move out. I mean, it's been how many years now? Looking for a house. All the things wrong with a house, even though the house is perfect and has everything you want. Then she gets a house. Now she can't move in until they get the carpet in. They got to fix the doors because they're too high on the carpet. She's got to get the driveway in, which is full of rocks, and she wants it over here.
Ramp to the building.
Exactly. She has all this stuff. So finally, she has all that stuff fixed.
Yeah.
And now she can't unpack her boxes.
And you realize it started last September.
It's got to be something else after the boxes. It's like, well, my house burned down. Cool. Didn't you say that she said something about it being over a mine?
Oh, my gosh. That's not
phosphorus
even...
Phosphorus gas? What
no,
was it again?
Methane gas.
Methane gas.
There's an old coal gas. Mine within
so,
a few hundred yards.
It's going to blow up.
But look, they built a highway by this mine. And there's businesses.
It's going to blow up.
If I'd known that, I would never got it.
You walk over there and you drop a lighter or a cigarette, you're
well,
dead.
Well, look, if you didn't want a house near an old mine, you shouldn't have moved here.
That someone should have. She should have known that. She seems all the coal. I'm dedicated to coal mining and the coal miners walking around. Come on. Okay, so that was our last play on the table because our system still does not recognize the Ontario Tac 2.
Here it is.
So,
we're on social media sites like Instagram, Facebook, Pinterest, Reddit, YouTube, IGTV, and Parler, which I haven't posted on. I don't think anybody's posted on in 10 days now because it still won't let us.
Yep. So Parler might have to just...
Part.
Go.
Parler ways.
Speaking of YouTube, though, guys, please make sure to like, share, comment, and subscribe on our YouTube video. That way, we're not only the ones getting a little something out of this, because when you do, you can enter an AK giveaway.
There it is. Right now on YouTube's AK... and Steel Wheel are giving away the Steel Wheel Janiya. While over on the AK blog, they're still giving away the Steel Wheel 230 Druid.
I'm not getting that one. Sorry.
Yep.
Answer the AK trivia question, you'll be entered to win. Also, quick mention, the answer to the question is a little hint at our monthly big giveaway.
No way, is it?
So keep that in mind for future episodes.
I might have to go read it.
Wow, thanks. With that bomb dropped.
I'm seeing this is
Jul.
Just Jul, and we are... signing off.